or to have a family.
So we have 1,515 students.
This class has around 360 students. The ninth grade class has 455. Okay, so more than likely, if you remember last year, our freshman class was around 420. So we're growing each year, which is a good problem to have. Okay, that means that we get more resources. We have more students that we have to serve, but we get more resources as well. So 1,515, we are the largest high school in the city. Behavioral expectations. This is not something that I really think that I have to go over, but just as more or less as a reminder. The expectation is that your behavior will be appropriate. Okay? We only have these assemblies 4 times a year normally. And so at these assemblies, I remind you of these things, and the expectation is that when we have them, that you listen, so that if there's any questions later, you know that you've received the information. Metal detector etiquette. Some things that we've asked you to do a little bit differently this year, and which I want to say thank you for, because you've been listening to them even by just having to hear it word of mouth in the morning, is your keys and your cell phones, making sure that you place those inside your bag. And the reason why we're asking you to do that is when you have those on your person and you're going through the metal detector, it makes you beep, right? And so if you don't have those on you and then you don't have any other metal, you won't beep and you'll be able to just go through the metal detector without having to be checked. This does a couple of different things. Number one, it helps you to not have to be checked. Number two, it helps us to have a quicker route in the morning. Over 1,500 students, it takes a lot of time to get people in the morning. And so this helps us out quite a bit. And so I want to thank you guys for being willing to do this. You've done a good job so far. Another thing to help the process in the morning is to unzip your backpacks. So if you have a bag and you don't unzip it, it's really hard for the person who's checking it because then they have to stop, unzip, they have to search it, then they have to put it on the table. It just adds probably, another 30 seconds to the process. And if you're checking, some of you carry 2 and 3 bags. So we're checking probably 2,300 bags a day in that morning intake. So please make sure that you're doing this. When we begin to have IDs again, which will probably be the last week in September, just making sure you have that ID available. Mrs. Garnett last year, she entered in so many people's names by hand that she probably could name every student in the whole school because someone forgot, at least one person forgot it every day. And that's being generous to say one, it was more like 50. So please make sure that if you lose your ID, that you come and you see us. At the beginning of this year, if you lost it from last year, we will print you a new one free of charge for the first for this first month. But then after that, you'll have to pay for one. It's $3. Just make sure that you have your ID on you. And you'll get more information about when we're going to start these in the next week. It's still going to be your old picture. I take my ID. We're gonna print new cards every other year. I'll wait. We're gonna print new cards every other year. The cost to print the cards is very, very expensive. Like very expensive. And so that's the reason why we're choosing to print the other year. Okay, home room. So home room is never optional. And that's something that you have to remember. Last year, Mrs. Genter spent hours on her own time at home clearing up home room attendance. With our new system, we can't clear it up anymore. There's no way to clear it up. So if it goes in as unexcused because you didn't show up for home room, it's going to stay unexcused. And so you know that home room attendance is used for problems readiness. So if you're here in the school, like we send out an attendance bulletin every day, and every day there's 120 kids on there that we've seen 60 of them throughout the day, for sure. I usually go through and say, I saw her, I saw him, he talked to me today, but there's no way of cleaning it up to say, oh yeah, you're definitely here. So homeroom is 12 minutes of your life. Please go, because it does affect you. Please stay. If I hear, oh, my teacher said I could go, that means you didn't go. Because your teachers know that you have to stay there. So please stay there. It's 12 minutes, you get the announcements in the morning. We pass out important paperwork if you need that, things like that. Just please make sure that you go to homeroom. It's very important to attend. In terms of the gym, you'll notice that we have one ramp this year. It's the one closest to the main office. We had to shut down the other one because of water leaking. There was water leaking from the ceiling. And so that has been shut down until they can repair it. So that means that you're using that one ramp to go down, using that ramp to come up. Just some reminders about the gym area. If you're going to leave stuff in there that's valuable, so if you're going to leave your phone or your money or your wallet or whatever it may be, please use a lock to secure your locker. Or leave that in your locker upstairs and just bring what you need to the gym for that period. You want to make sure that your stuff is safe. Unfortunately, we do have students who have sticky fingers, is the nicest way to put it. Okay, so you want to make sure that you guard against the fact that you don't want to lose your stuff, so please lock your stuff up. Another thing to take into consideration about the gym is if you're not scheduled to be in the gym, please don't be in the gym. This week, we're going to be meeting with teachers. It's going to be their duty that during gym class, they're going to go down at the start of class. They're going to say, does anybody not belong? Anybody that doesn't belong is going to be shooed upstairs and away, and they're going to sit at the entry to the gym on the top floor. And if you don't belong here, we're going to have a list of who does. They're going to tell you, you don't belong here. Go away. And so here's the unfortunate part about this, because it's not funny, because last year, the number of people who received D's and E's in classes was primarily because they cut class at the gym. And so, if anyone knows me and knows what my expectations are, it's that you're successful. And your success matters to me and to your teachers and to the rest of the staff, because this is your future. We have a future that we've already established. We've gone to school, we've gotten educations. This is your education. And so we are going to take this step because we don't want people down there when they're not supposed to be down there, because it's eating up your valuable education time. Dress code. You guys have been doing a fairly decent job with this. The first 2 weeks of school were so hot that the leniency that we used was not our typical, okay? It was very, very hot. You guys have done a nice job transitioning to the cooler weather, you know, making sure that you have appropriate attire on. Just remembering that we are a school. It's not a party. Probably if it's something that you would wear to a party, it's probably not appropriate for here. And just being mindful of that. Some other things to take into consideration is making sure that you're not wearing clothes that's offensive to other people, whether it be different phrases that you see on clothing or pictures that would be inappropriate for school. Just always being mindful of what you're wearing to make sure that it's appropriate for the school day. Other things, and some of these we could probably remove. I see probably less sad hands than I've ever seen, which is always a positive. It means that hopefully the trend has gone towards more appropriate wear. But you guys have done a good job with that. Just some more reminders. I'm not going to read them to you. You can take a look at them for yourself as to what our expectations are. Electronic devices. I'm sure you've noticed that your teachers, there's quite a few that have been starting to use your electronic devices like during class, right? They may say, hey, use it as a calculator, or they may say, we're going to take a quick survey, you're going to use it by punching in this number, whatever it may be. Just making sure that if they ask you to use it, that's when you use it. If they're not asking you to use it, they're asking you to have a way that you put it away. Allderdice does give you the benefit of being able to use it in the hallways and to use it in the lunchroom. And that's not something that all schools do. So if you want to keep that privilege, we just ask that you respect the fact that they shouldn't be used in the classroom unless instructed to use by the teacher. Hallway behavior, moving quickly. 1,500 students, it gets really tight. The first day of school, I knew that we were much larger when the second floor, when you add all the freshmen, and they've never been to the second floor, and it was like literally people were on top of each other. And so that's why it's really important to move quickly from class to class so that we're not backing it up and we're not kind of having people waiting to get through. Standing around is never a good thing. Walking and talking is definitely a good thing. And if a teacher asks you to move and you don't know who they are, being respectful to them rather than being angry at them. Because I'm asking them to ask you to move because we know that you should be moving. So please be respectful to them as well. Cafeteria expectations. Junior and senior lunches are so nice. I have to tell you guys that the freshman lunch is like, there's like little space for that. You know, there's close to 500 of them. It's very loud. Junior and senior lunch is so nice. You guys have done a really good job of keeping the tempo low. There's no like yelling and screaming. I'm appreciative of that. The only thing I ask the juniors to do, and I ask the seniors to do this too, is to clean up. And so, you know, when you go to college, you're not going to, like, leave your stuff on the table because that would be embarrassing for you because, like, you know, adults clean up after themselves. And so as we're transitioning and getting older, it's really important that you clean up. You know that the time in between lunches is very tight. And so the custodian has to clean all the tables. Then the lunch lady has to go through and clean all the tables off, like, with a rag. So if you guys clean up first, that would give us less time that we have to clean up and more time that we can let kids come in quickly. Because I'm sure you can imagine the 9th and 10th grade lunches, they're so crowded that in the hallway it's really crowded. And so we don't like to leave them out there too long. So if you guys could help in cleaning up, that would be really, really great and very much so appreciated. And just reminders that if you want to leave the cafeteria, you do need to have a note. We don't want people wandering to the gym or just wandering to the halls. Attendance. So I see Mrs. Genter just left. She's going to leave me to be the attendance information giver. But attendance is very, very important. If you ever think that attendance isn't important, it is. I mean, when you get out of school and you go to college, no one's going to look for you. So if you don't establish the habits now, it's going to be really bad in college. I had friends who, like, didn't go to college classes, and then at the end got bad grades and wondered why they got bad grades. Well, it's because you didn't learn anything. And so it's the same thing with high school. Do you want to say anything, Mrs. Genter?
You've done a wonderful job.
This class has been great in terms of, you know, bringing the attendance rate up and keeping it. And it shows in what your grades are, too. Because if you're here, then you can be educated and do well. Okay?
Yeah, the junior and senior class have the two highest class readiness percentages. So we're appreciative of that, but it means that you're doing what you need to do. But we want to make sure that you keep up with it. The other thing to take into consideration is when you're absent, you have 4 days to turn in the notes, so 4 school days. And you have 10 parent notes per year for absences. So if you're out the whole entire day, 10 parent notes. If you come tardy to school, you have 10 parent notes. And if you have an early dismissal, you have 10 parent notes. So that's a lot. That's a lot. And so, you know, there are people who burn through their parent notes and then they're like, I'm unexcused, or they're making them know things like that. So just make sure that you're mindful of these. It seems like, we just want to make sure that you have the information so you don't make the choices that lead you in a bad way.
So our goal is 90% in-class attendance. So even if I have students that are medically, even though they're medically excused, we're going to work with you and your family
and your doctors to make sure that we can provide you with the education, whether it's a need for homebound or an alternative schedule or whatever it is. Of course, as well as in colleges, if you are there 90%.
Absent a class and there's no note, it's unexamined. You must complete the work that you missed. It's very important for you to be here. It's on a lanyard that has their name at the bottom. If you're leaving, there was an issue with the printer. They got backed up, they had a mistake, they had to redo them. So they should be in probably in the next week, and we'll distribute those in homeroom. Those planners should be used. If you're leaving, say, to go from one class to another, and class has already started and you're not going back to that class, that's when a teacher would fill out your planner and make sure that you can get to that other class without being stopped. 100% of your grade, no matter what, in every class. And homework can kill you. It can take you from an A to a B, a B to a C, a C to a D, or even a D to a B. So it's very, very important to do homework. This is another thing that you'll see in college. It's worth a lot, because everything that you do will mostly be outside of class. And you're not going to get points for showing up. You're going to get points for what you turn in after the fact. New social hall in the south side. There is free parking there, which is one of the reasons why we selected the venue. And it's also really large. We normally have about 400 students who come to